Hey yo,
America, fuck yeah. Hey, it's Nerdcore Dave. I want to introduce you guys to a friend of mine.
This little fella right here, his name is Spy Dog. He is a variant of a product made around 2005 by Sega and distributed by Hasbro called an iDog. Now, a normal iDog was a lot more plain than this, but this is a promotional item for Spider-Man 3, so they had a black suit Venom 1 and a red and blue Spy Dog as well. So basically the idea behind these things is it was an update on the 90s Tamagotchi / Gigapet craze. And what you could do is you would have this guy, here, let's turn him on, and he would basically, depending on how you played with him, he would have his own little personality and react differently to different situations. So different kinds of music makes him react differently. Wow, you can see he's very demanding, just like a real dog. But so depending on what kind of music you play, he would react differently and he would get a different personality. You could play music, he could react to sound, so he's reacting to me talking right now. But also, hey, when you see when he gets red is when he gets agitated. And you gotta pet him. But you would jack the music in and have that little speaker right there. See that? That's a speaker. And you could play music through him that way too. And then he has this little, right on his little ass here, he has this toggle. And I don't know if this is gonna, it does affect him sometimes. I think his ear's up, meaning he's kind of pissed off. I'm not sure. You better get used to that, buddy. You better get used to being pissed off around here, man. But see, there's a little sensor right there, that light sensor. So you gotta have good lighting when you use them. But it's supposed to, that's how you kind of care for him. And the music actually counts as food for him. So that's how you feed him. He'll want, when he wants fed, you have to play music for him. So yeah, kind of a nifty little guy. I was looking on eBay and I can't believe it. If you still have the box and everything for him, these things are going anywhere from, I saw $25 to $100. Which is crazy. I don't remember them. Aw, poor guy. I don't remember them being that popular, but apparently there's a market for him. So I don't know. Maybe he'll join us on some of our Nerdcore escapades. So there you have it, Spy Dog. We got to come up with a name for you. Maybe Peter. What do you think? We'll see how he likes that. But until then, let's get this party started. All right, let's wake this little some bitch up. Aye, dog, wakey wakey, eggs and barky. Whoa. I think this some bitch might have the rabies. Whoa. Easy with the attitude, bro. All right, so check it out, guys. We made that trip down to the city this weekend. And guess what? Success. We rocked it out. As it turns out, I've got an entire stack of CGCs here. But we're going to be doing that, I don't know if at a later date, maybe later this show, I don't know. But while we were down there, I definitely did some grabs. I made those trades I told you guys about. And I actually, dude, that Alice in Chains fetched me a handsome sum. So did a little shopping for just the essentials, just the necessities today. So let's check it out. One of the books that I did not see at my local comic shop, and I kind of wanted to get just because of my Wolvie collection. I don't know how much, if I'm really invested in wanting to know about this, but cool cover, definitely a cool Wolverine edition. The Wolverine Infinity Watch, number one, numero uno. Just the A cover, badass, says it all. And like I said, it's a good addition to the Wolverine collection. Now, like I said, it was Ted, Janine, Snuff, and myself. And while we were pissing around, me and Snuff went down and bebopped around a little bit, and we checking out the spinner racks that have like kind of the back issues on it.
And last night I watched that Hot 10 list, so I saw there was a couple of Venom number 9 there, so I'm like, I wonder. So I took a... What's up, bud? So I took a... let's pet his tail. Oh, he's not getting too excited. So I looked at the Venom number 9s, and as it turned out, right in the back, guess what? This thing's up to $25, I think, on the Hot 10 list this week. So that was a win in itself, man. Hashtag Venomous. But also, I checked the back issues because I did not have one of these. And I ended up finding two more. But I grabbed one for the low. This is actually the cheapest I've seen this thing. The Marvel Point One, $10. First appearance of Kamala Khan, Ms. Marvel. That's a win. So I finally got that added to the collection. Right here, let me see. Let's pet your ass. Let's pet your stinking ass. Come on, buddy. There we go. So, anyways, I went and did a little digging in their back issues and checked the... what's up, buds? Here, let's do this. So, I went and checked around the Archie comics, and they had some of those Christian Spire comics there. You know, Archie actually... half the time they were Christian or Spire Christian comics, and then they became Archie Spire Christian comics. So they had Dan Wilkerson's The Cross and the Switchblade. Now I know Todd has one of these, and this is also, it's by Al Hartley again. Todd has one of these, so we plan on doing a review on this sumbitch coming up soon here. Well, I shouldn't say soon because we've got another one here. Another one they had there is Attack. I'm not sure it's... by Mitsuo Fuchida, as told by Elizabeth Sherrill and Al Hartley. So apparently in World War II, it shows how, let's face it, it's going to be an extremist, but they're converting to Japanese to Christianity. I'm very interested to see how that plays out. Then I happened to see that also right in front, I was like, hey, I need that one. It was Immortal Hulk number 5, Cinco. So now I only need issue number 3, and then I'll have the whole series, except for number 2 would be third printing, and everything else is first printing, so that's exciting. Can't wait to read this shit and see what all the hype's about. Then I did a little digging. I was like, I couldn't understand why I had this on my list, and I was like, maybe when I see the cover, I'll remember. Well, sure as shit, when I saw the cover, I was like, oh yeah. And it's funny because Todd popped up right about that, and I'm like, hey, Todd, check this out. So he looked, and there was actually a second one in there, so he grabbed one of these two. Action Comics 457, and guys, I blocked out the word balloons just so you could see how interesting this cover is. I'm not sure what is happening. What is going on, guys? Again, an interesting cover. Innuendo, I don't know, disturbing, certainly. But here, as it turns out, this guy here is upset because Superman won't tell him his secret identity, allegedly, if that's what's really going on. We don't know. So yeah, Todd and I both cut one of those. Now, for the one that I asked them to hold on to for me, and I keep saying I was going to pick this up, will you settle? Well, he's getting excited. He knows the hype. Believe the hype. Believe the hype. The hype is real. So, anyways, this is the one I asked him to save me, and I was able to grab this up today with those trades and stuff. So, I'm pretty happy to get this. This definitely falls into the low grade is better than no grade category. I don't see how I would ever get a 9.8 or anything, but what it is Fantastic Four number 52. First appearance of T'Challa, the Black Panther. But if you look, this has been photocopied and attached the top. Now, if you look how that's a straight line cut across the top, what used to happen is whenever people would return to the distributor, they would cut the top off of their comics, and then they were supposed to throw the rest away. So I'm assuming that's what this is. But regardless, again, low grade better than no grade. They have this graded at a 0.75. Honestly, I'd still CGC it. It's still worth money. I know what I paid for it, and that's not cheap for a 0.75. It was fair. It was actually probably more than fair. But again, it's going to have that oddball CGC. If you, the header plate's going to be, I think that might be red. So regardless, I'm going to be sending that out. And I'm going to be sending some more stuff out. I'm going to be looking through my collection to see what I'm going to be sending out here soon. I'm kind of leaning towards that Hulk 181, getting that over with. Yeah, so I guess that's it for now, and iDog and I are going to go play some Star Wars and maybe watch some Umbrella Academy. iDog, hit the music. Yo, survey time. Are you here to see Blondcore Janine? Or are you here to see Nerdcore Dave?
I think that's me.
All right, so what are we doing today, Arlene?
I wanted to show the couple CGCs that I picked up. And
why just, didn't you pick up more? You only picked up a couple?
That's all I had out was two.
Pussy.
I have four more out now. But
four. Oh, really? Four?
I have four. Ooh. Yeah.
Hold on. Before, let's, not everything's so, about you, Janine. So we got to get started. This is our new mascot. We busted out the spy dog.
Okay.
Can we get him going here? Did you see how he works? Watch.
How is he?
This is his power button. Look at him. He's adorable. So he's supposed to work to music, but he'll listen to us talk and then we'll react.
Yeah.
Amazing. Yay. Go spy dog. It. We love you.
We love you.
There's not real good lighting in here right now, but if you, there's a little sensor right there. Uh-huh. So when you pet him, you want to pet him in the light.
Okay.
It, look. He loves it. Look.
He loves it.
So that's how you, then you feed him with music.
Oh.
And don't ask me how he poops because I don't know. But you can also, you mute him by pushing his little, see his little ass right there? Mm-hmm. Is a toggle, and you push that toggle and it'll mute for a minute, and then his nose is like when you're petting him. Oh yeah, let, see, he don't like that. You got to build up his personality. He's a little puppy. He's still a puppy now.
He doesn't like that.
Yeah, he didn't like that one. It's like shoving his nose in shit or something. Like he don't like that. Bad memories, flashbacks.
Don't do
he has
that.
PTSD.
Poor puppy.
Puppy traumatic stress disorder.
Poor little puppy.
So
he's
anyway,
he's a cute puppy.
Yeah, they have red and blue ones. But he's been in there for a while, and I just busted him out last night. Isn't he awesome?
He's cute.
All right, so we got. Okay. What are we going to do? We want to do your weekend haul first?
Yeah, we can do that. Well, first I wanted to show the one that I actually won.
You won?
I did. I won.
How did you win?
I entered a giveaway on Instagram.
Oh.
Yeah.
How'd you find that? Probably a hell of a nice guy. Probably goes by DatLocoLatino6 on Instagram, probably.
Yeah, kind of. Maybe.
Might have tagged you in a contest.
Might have tagged me in a contest. I don't know. So
who was it? Who was the contest from?
It was Chloe's. I have it here. It's Chloe's Comics and Collectibles. And they're actually out of Nevada.
Nevada.
So, you say Nevada.
What was the contest? What'd you have to do?
You had to like their page. You had to
tag
three people, like three friends, and I think that was it. Like I don't think you had to repost or anything like that. It was just kind of like that kind of thing. But
you really lucked out. I don't have any friends, so that's why I tagged you. We're being honest here, right?
We are.
All right, so Chloe's Comics and Collectibles on Instagram, thank you.
Yes, thank you so much. They messaged me and told me that I had won, and this came in the mail for me, and it is Thor 339, which is the first appearance and origin of Beta Ray Bill's Stormbreaker.
Which was in the MCU?
Yes.
What, in Avengers?
Which one was that?
What is that, Endgame?
Endgame?
Yeah. So that's what he's not a little person. He's a big little person. He's the guy, what's his name? Dimitri or something, or Itri. He made it in there. It's totally different in the comics. Yeah,
because when you were explaining it to me, I'm like, oh, that is not how it was. I wish
there's a lot of people wish they would have brought in Beta Ray Bill. And actually, if you watch the Thor Ragnarok, if you watch the Grandmaster's castle,
he's
Beta Ray Bill's face is on there. So he was one of the warriors, and actually he was in Planet Hulk's comic storyline. So
that, I think that would have been cool if they would have brought him in there, but you know they didn't. But that was nice.
They still can.
Yeah, they still can.
Sarah Jessica Parker's gonna play him.
That's not nice.
It's a true story.
It's not nice.
I'm killing it today.
Oh,
I'm all hopped up on the caffeine and the Folgers.
Lord. Okay.
Oh, we're not recording.
Are you kidding me?
Psych. And a funny eyed dog here.
This happened before. It happened before. True story. We thought we were recording and we were not.
So, I think this is the third appearance of Beta Ray Bill, by the way.
Oh, okay, cool.
So I think 337 was his first appearance, 338, and then 339. Okay. 338, he battles Thor, and then 339, he's in front of Odin. Odin's like, here, just take his fucking hammer and go away, dude. All right, so then yesterday when we went to pick up our CGCs,
yes,
and then we did a little bit of hunting too, huh?
Yeah, only got a couple things, but I got Sharky number one, Sharky the Bounty Hunter number one, I must say.
And this is based on the Jaws movies?
No.
Oh.
No, he's a bounty hunter. And apparently, I don't...
Why didn't they release this for Shark Week? That would have been awesome.
That would have been a good idea.
That would have been sweet. All right.
Yeah. They might have, but actually, it is supposed to be in production, I guess.
Shark Week?
No.
Oh. The Shark. Yeah. What's the name? Sharky.
Sharky.
Jaws. Whatever. You're exhausting.
I'm exhausted already. But it's a story about, he's a bounty hunter who flies through the universe in his rocket-powered ice cream truck.
Oh, he's in the universe?
Yeah, he tracks down criminals across the universe in his souped-up rocket-powered ice cream truck.
Hmm.
So, I don't know.
Seems like he's kind of like Lobo.
It does sound similar to that, but I don't know. That might be, I don't know, I hate to say, like, if that's what they're basing it on, but it does sound, I haven't read it yet, but there might be some similarities.
What else did you get, Janine?
I got Avengers No Road Home number 2.
What?
I do have number 1. I didn't read either of them.
I didn't read it yet. I was thinking, I was actually put it out. I was like, you know what, I need to get on this, because it's weekly, and I really want to keep up with it, because it's going
to
be awesome.
Yeah, so I really have to start reading these, but it's the first appearance of Hypnos.
Who?
Hypnos.
Hypnos. Like hypnotized? Like
I'm guessing maybe I don't know, maybe that's a power, I don't know.
Or maybe he's just a hypocrite. There's a lot of that going around these days.
There is.
All right, so Avengers No Road Home 2, the Yasmin Putri.
Yes.
I guess not the variant, the main cover.
I think this is the only one. I don't know,
I think there was a variant, wasn't there?
I don't know if they had the variant or not.
Okay. But there is a variant somewhere.
There is. Okay. But I'm not sure what they had, but I picked this one up. I thought it was cool. So then I got Thanos 15.
You threw some money out.
I did. A little bit of money. And this is the origin of the Cosmic Ghost Rider.
Hi, Oi.
Hi, Oi.
Feel free to insert yourself whenever you feel like it.
I'm gonna have a kitty on my lap for the rest of the video. Okay.
All right. So that is what.
So
a badass cover.
It's you know what, I know it does have the origin of, like I said, the origin of the Cosmic Ghost Rider, but that is an awesome cover.
With Hulk all tied up like that.
I had
in
like
bondage. He's his gimp.
It's
like straight out of Pulp Fiction.
Like who can control the Hulk like that?
Yeah.
Seriously. Like, have you ever seen
that? He's got a Fu Manchu. I didn't notice that. I never noticed that before.
It's like, who actually, you know, has control over the Hulk like that?
That's a cool book. I'm a tiny bit jelly on that one.
It's actually cool. I was between three. There was a Deadpool one that I had a Deadpool one.
The Headpool cover.
Then, of course, the Guardians. I have not. I really want the Guardians, but I just could not.
That's the Guardians. They have the Guardians, the one when they first used the people from the movie.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes. But they had that, and but then I, you know, I just I love the cover on that one.
Groovy.
Yeah.
Okay.
So everything else I got at my local comic shop yesterday.
You ran to the LCS.
Because I want to do those. I want to do those.
I can set this one over here somewhere, so it's safe forever.
Yeah.
Forever.
Yeah, you can watch him. Yeah?
Okay.
So at my local comic shop, I got a couple True Believers, Conan True Believers. Got one.
What is that? Let me see. We don't know which issues these are. We don't know what they're reprinting.
I don't know. It just says True Believers. Curse of the Golden Skull. Okay. I don't know. He had so many there.
Yeah, yeah. All those Conan ones are coming out right now.
And I was trying to go through them all.
This one looks like it's from one of the Conan magazines, painted covers.
I thought that was
probably Savage Sword.
I thought that was pretty cool.
This is
like the cover.
Okay, and then this one is actually Conan number one, the first appearance of Conan in comics. Then,
yeah, so I got that. I got three of those.
Then you got that sweet.
I got the Nightwing 57
variant. I forget who did that. They said
I wrote it on here. It's Jeff. How do you say that? Dickhol.
Okay. Jeff Dickhol.
Yeah, I don't know. Like.
Okay.
How you, yeah. But,
is that how you pronounce it? Say it. Say it.
I don't say it that way. I'm going to say decal. Decal. I'm not going to do it. but it also said on there that it's the return of the Joker's daughter.
Oh. Yeah. That's right. It was on the main cover. It was on the main cover.
So, but I liked that. I liked this variant cover. So he had one of those. So I thought, what the hell, right? But the reason I went was actually because Dave had him hold one of these copies for me, and only because it is a Mateena variant cover, and it is just cool. I love it. I mean, the colors. I like purple, so.
That is a beautiful cover.
It's all.
When I first saw that, I was like, oh my God. Because it doesn't look like a standard. Mateena covers are usually so dark.
Yeah. They're very dark. They're very, I don't know what to say, but like, this is bright and colorful, and this is awesome.
Did you look at the interior at all?
I did not.
The interior looks awesome.
Really?
Yeah. I want to get another copy.
I have to check it out. But yeah, he had him hold that for me, so I just had to go get that. Right away. Just wanted to go. And then, I picked up those couple other books.
So from your LCS, probably the two best covers are Mateena, mm-hmm. and then the Jeff Dickhol Nightwing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That guy.
All right. So okay. Then what? Now we picked up our CGCs,
we
huh?
We picked up our CGCs. And I only had two, of course. One was the Return of Wolverine number one.
Is that the Jeff Dickhol cover?
No, it isn't.
Oh, okay.
No, he has nothing to do with that.
Oh, okay.
But it is the Error edition. And it has, on the notes, it has manufactured with two pages, replaced from Dr. Alpha, number 25.
Dr. Alpha. Look, you're upsetting him. Look what you're doing. You're getting this dog Afra. Upset. You're getting Spy Dog upset.
I'm not getting him upset. You're getting him upset. But 9.8 on that. Return of Wolverine.
Awesome. Yeah. What else does it say? It says says second printing error edition.
Yes.
Then it also has the pages, and then that's about it, right?
Yeah, I think that's pretty much
it. That's a really cool cover, too.
I do like that. I honestly thought that, like, all of ours would, like, especially with these, that they would come back high.
Yeah, oh, yeah, because we got those. Yeah. I mean, they pretty much...
They were pretty nice.
Oh, my God, he's so demanding.
Yeah, see, no decal on that one.
Spy Dog. No. I think he has to poop.
Maybe he's hungry.
Talk more. No, don't do that. All right, so what else did you get?
So,
that looks really nice encapsulated. That's a nice looking book.
You know what?
Let's put that back up there and look at it.
I like the color.
That's a nice looking
book. I don't know. It's like the colors that they have together on there with the blue and the purple and the yellow. Like, they all... it's such a nice blend. It's a nice cover. But I also got Deadpool number 5.
What's...
It's the Garbage Pail Kids trading cards homage cover.
Ooh, you've seen it. It was a hot cover a couple months ago, right?
It was Yeah, it was a pretty hot cover a couple months ago, and I don't know if these are.
That's another one that just looks nice encapsulated,
yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, it does. I have two of them, and I took what I thought was the nicer one, but I mean the other one's not bad either. But that one also got a 9.8. I was happy with that.
What does it say on the header? What's it say exactly?
It just says Deadpool 305, Garbage Pail Kids Trading Cards Homage Cover.
Sweet.
So yeah.
Not a homage cover, like I hear everybody else say, homage. No, it's not homage.
It's not homage. It's not, dear God, it's not homage. It's an homage.
It's an homage.
But, yes.
Homage. Oh, yeah. Homage.
Reckless Wade.
Cool. That's a cool one to get.
That's pretty cool, right?
Yeah, it looks really good in that CGC.
It looks nice in there.
So, they're both 9.8s. Yes. What were you expecting for both of them?
I honestly didn't think of it. I thought maybe like 9.4, 9.6.
Wow.
I don't know. Like, I know they were like brand new and in like I was careful with them, but I don't know. I just didn't expect it to be. I didn't expect 9.8s.
You hope for 9.8s.
I hope.
But you always kind of brace yourself that it's not going to be
a 9.8. You hope for 9.8s, but you know, you could just kind of got to keep it under control because it's nice to get them, but I thought.
All yours are 9.8s right now, huh?
You
got that Spawn was a 9.8. Yeah. What else did you get?
No, the Spider-Man.
Oh, that's right. The Spike 9.4? Is that what it was?
I think it's a 9.4.
Yeah, 9.4, that's still pretty good.
Yeah.
That was a spectacular 90, the very first appearance of the black suit.
So, I do have four out now. I'm curious to see what they're going to come back as. I have Black Lightning number one.
And we thought that's going to be about, what, a six?
No, they at the shop, they guessed... 8.
Oh, and wow.
They guessed an 8.0 on that.
Okay.
Because whenever they were sending it out, he looked at it and he looks at me and he goes, I'm going to say this is going to come back an 8.0. But let's see if I'm right. I have that one out. I have my Daredevil, I'm not sure the number. It's the Death of Electra.
It's like 181 or something like that. I don't know.
And that one's actually, whenever I bought it, they had on it near mint.
Yeah. If it's over 9.2, it's a near mint. So it looked really nice. That's the nicest copy I've ever seen.
I'm hoping that, you know, for a good grade on that one. Yeah. So I have the Black Lightning. I have the Daredevil. I have the Venom number 3.
Okay.
Out. Which that one was in pretty.
Oh. Should be. It's still good. It's definitely going to be near mint, but I don't know if 9.8 or not.
And then I sent out my Rye number 0.
That's the one I was hoping you would send out.
Yeah. They had to press it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because whenever I was talking to them, they said that because I showed them how that was bent on the corner with the pages and everything. Because other than that,
they say they could get it out.
They said that they think with pressing it, they can get that.
Hey, man, even if it brings up a 0.2 or whatever, to invest the 10 bucks or whatever to have it always encapsulated forever.
Even if it brings it up, like you said, even a tiny little bit, but
I think you never have regrets.
No regrets. You never want to have any regrets. But I think it was how it was in the spinner, maybe, because like you could see the backing board was bent too.
Like somebody jammed it in there.
Yeah. So, but they told me that they think that with pressing it, they can get that out.
Dude,
so.
We got that. We found that for $2.33. So, or no, $1.66. It was $1.66.
Because they were a 3 for $5.
Yeah. So, I mean, listen, man.
I know.
So at the end of the day, what are they selling for on eBay? Like $300, right? Right now?
Yeah, like
they're hot. They're super hot.
CGC. Well, there's two different. Like you said, there's a shine. Like a what is it? A shinier cover.
There's a glossy one, and then just a regular matte.
But still, even the matte one is CGC. They're selling for probably around $300 or so. Right
for like a 9.6, 9.8. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm hoping that's the one. I'm gonna be real curious to see when it comes back.
That was on Comic Tom 101's. CBSI list this week. I think it was number one, wasn't it? The hot list? It was definitely up there. It was definitely on that list.
I didn't watch the last.
Somebody's not doing their homework. Somebody lacks dedication. Somebody's priorities are askew.
I didn't do my homework this week.
You knew this was going to be on the test.
I thought I could talk my way through it.
And you think these are all going to be at super high grade when you get them back?
I hope.
These came back a lot faster than I expected.
They did. So, and that's what I asked him. I said, whenever they're, because he told me there, I was worried about all four of mine coming back at the same time. And he said that they've been sending out all the time now, pretty much. Like before, they were only sent in certain times. But he said that they're sending more CGCs out now because they're getting, they're buying more, you know, getting, I don't know if more people.
A lot of collections and stuff.
Yeah, a lot of collections, things like that. So they're pretty much sending out all the time. So those ones I took down are already out. So, and then this other one will go out, I guess, I don't know, whenever. So we'll see. I mean, I'm hoping for some 9 point somethings.
Something I was just telling Janine about before we started this video was CGC just announced that they got a partnership with Marvel now. So like for $5 extra, this header right here will have a Marvel theme on it. And there's going to be a Spider-Man, Iron Man, Captain America, and Avengers themed ones for, again, $5. Yeah. So actually, I'm changing my idea on what I want to get graded. I'm kind of going a different route now because they said through 2019, which who knows, it could go forever.
But you don't know. They might not.
So I have a handful of Spideys, like First Carnage, the Spider-Man number ones, which I know aren't worth a lot of money, but they mean a lot to me, and I'd like to get one of each graded. Spider-Woman number one, I want to get the Spider-Man logo on there. And the Vision, I want to get the Avengers one on the Vision.
That's
one.
What I said. I think, I'm not sure, like I said, I'm going to have four, but like the next ones I want to do is, I'm thinking that, the first Nebula. Mm-hmm. The first Nebula.
Get that Avengers one on there.
Yeah, and get the Avengers on there. I think that's pretty cool that they're doing that. I don't know how they're, you know, I'm wondering what it's going to look like.
But now they're going to start doing that with DC and Image, and then, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but for $5 extra, I mean, you're already paying to have it. You're already paying how much to have it, CGC, so.
It's just like depressing. Like, why not spend the extra couple bucks and get that logo and make it really cool?
Yeah,
and
exactly.
And who knows, maybe it'll make it worth more because there'll only be X amount of them with... If not, they still has a cool logo on it, you know?
Yeah. Because, if you figure if they only do it for a certain time, you know, or, you might have...
You know, if they were smart, what they would do is change it every year. Like, every year, change the Spider-Man logo. Like, maybe use McFarlane 1 year, like a McFarlane box Spidey, and then maybe, you know what I mean, change it every year. Or they could do it per the decade. Do, like, the old school ones maybe have... I don't know, John Romita's Spider-Man, then in the 80s do Ron Friends, and then in the 90s have McFarlane. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That would be cool.
That would be a cool idea.
Like the hot artist. I don't know. But there's a lot of ways they could go with it, but I definitely want to take advantage of this while it's here, at least for a moment. So,
I would like, like I said, you know, extra couple dollars.
I know she didn't get any of those ones that look like, what the hell is it called, where it looks like an oil stain on it. Yours look crystal clear.
Yeah.
They look good, man.
I don't know if that's something that would develop in time, though.
Nah, usually you tell
when
right
you get
away.
Them back.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, all right.
Okay.
Are we done?
We're done. That's pretty much all I got.
Are we going to nerdcore out?
We're going to nerdcore out.
Okay. Say it to me. Say nerdcore out.
Nerdcore out.
If I had the power to gather all of my favorite MCs with the illest comic book characters, and they became arch enemies. Inconceivable, unbelievable, yet as wild as it seems. The Emperor and Stan Lee were coached the two opposing teams. Keep it clean, no bats.